In a world with so many questions, and only so many answers.
Who's here to answer all of life's biological questions?
It's Jake!
And Jared!
But!
This ain't your grandmother's biology. This is hardcore biology.
Ah!
Hello, I'm Jake.
And I'm Jared.
And this is hardcore biology.
Now, you may notice that this is not very hardcore. Well, due to the recent passing of our dear assistant Bobby and low ratings, we've decided to tone the show down a bit. Isn't that right, Jake?
That is correct, Jared.
By the way, Bobby, don't drink that substance that's in the bottle over there. Butler!
Here are the croissants you wished for.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Ken. Sir.
We have very good news for you today. Our dear friend, Dr. Pearson Gillespie, will be joining us.
And he's going to be here to discuss the very important topic of evolution.
Now to our first topic of conversation.
Genetic drift. Genetic drift. A random change in allele frequencies over time brought about by chance.
We'll explain genetic drift in terms of probability. If you were to flip a coin, the chances of it landing on heads is 50%. However, if you were to flip 10 coins, that percentage might differ. As you near 1,000 coins flipped, the probability of it being heads would be 50%.
Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. There are random allele changes in populations. Random change in allele frequencies can lead to a loss of genetic diversity and to the homozygous condition.
When all of the individuals of a population become homozygous for one allele, we say that fixation has occurred.
Butler?
Donuts are for you, sir.
Oh, I thank you.
And for you, sir.
Splendid.
Now to our next topic, reproductive isolation.
Indeed, a splendid topic. In nature, sexually reproducing species attain and maintain separate identities by reproductive isolation. New species arrive through the evolutionary process of speciation.
What is speciation, you ask? Well, I can tell you. Speciation is when populations diverge genetically as mutation, natural selection, and genetic drift operate independently.
Reproductive isolating mechanisms are heritable traits of body form, function, or behavior that prevent interbreeding between different species. Now on to another dicey topic, mutations. Mutations can occur during DNA replication, or they can be due to high exposure to radiation, or chemicals.
Gene sequences of chromosomes change when one base is substituted for another, an extra base is inserted, or when one is lost. There are many mutations in this world. However, the most common are base pair substitutions, deletions, and insertions. These may either be helpful, harmful, or have no effect at all.
Oh, he's here. I'll get the door. You can stay here. This is our good friend, Pearson Gillespie. He's the expert on everything Charles Darwin and evolution. Ah, how
Hello.
Are you, sir?
My good friend Jared.
Good day.
How are you? Good day.
Now, Pearson, can you tell the viewers at home what you were here to talk to us about again?
Why, yes, my good sir. That would be evolution!
As you can see, Dr. Pearson Gillespie is very excited about evolution. That's why we brought him into the show.
Now, my favorite area of evolution is evolutionary adaptation. This is when a trait improves an individual's odds of survival.
Now, consider this llama. Llamas are native to the Andes Mountains in South America, where they live 16,000 feet above sea level. Now, being up that high makes it very hard to breathe, but llamas, through evolutionary adaptation, have developed a trait that's great for them to live up there. They have more blood vessels and air sacs in their lungs, and their heart has larger chambers so it can pump a larger volume of blood.
Now, coevolution, that's a whole other story. Coevolution is a process by which close ecological interaction among species causes them to evolve together.
Hope you had a fun time at Hardcore Biology.
Bang, bang, bang!
And make sure to join us next week.
where we study the planaria and regeneration.
That was horrible.
Now, a wise man might notice that this is not very hardcore.
Hey, wait. Do you want recording, so stop recording.
Butler!
For you,
so
thank you.
Are you kidding? We're filming!
Thanks, Jared. Now everyone knows some animals that are a result of injuries, like liger, a wolfen, or even a sorce.
Oh my.
But not everybody's familiar with the lemur. Luckily, we caught a wild bird a few minutes ago.
Look at that over there.
That's what
you're gonna do. Is that a lemur? Oh my gosh, look at this. Uncle Drew!
Big shot. Name of the game. There are many mutations in this world. However, the most common are...
Dominic, the expert on all things biology and evolution...
Jared, there's a monster outside! Jared, there's a monster!
Now, Pearson. Can you tell the viewers at home what you're here to talk to us about again?
So there are all these llamas, right? And they're all like, hey guys, come on, I'm up too high, I can't breathe. But then one guy's just like, come on guys, I can breathe. And they all just listen to him and they're like, hey guys, we can breathe now. This is evolution!
Success.
I hope
you
learned a lot
about genetic drift. Don't
Jake smells. Jake smells really bad. We've barely been able to film this because Jake has smelled so bad.